going to start the second chapter of English, Alice in Wonderland. This is a story from a famous novel of Lewis Carroll. This is a story which is called as fantasy adventure. What is fantasy adventure? When an adventure story takes place in an imaginary land with magical creatures, it is called a fantasy adventure. You may have heard about or seen movie like Jungle Book or Harry Potter. These are the examples of fantasy adventure. Now let us see what happened with Alice in this story. One day, Alice was sitting in her garden. Suddenly, she saw a rabbit run past her into a rabbit hole. The rabbit was talking to itself and looking at the pocket watch to check the time. Alice decided to follow the rabbit and she jumped into the hole after it. What happened next? Let us see. Alice found herself in a long low hall which was lit up by a row of lamps hanging from the roof. There were doors all round the hall, but they were all locked. And when Alice had been all the way down one side and up the other, trying every door, she walked sadly down the middle, wondering how she was ever to get out again. Suddenly, she came upon a little three-legged table all made of solid glass. There was nothing on it except a tiny golden key. And Alice's first thought was that it might belong to one of the doors of the hall. But alas, either the locks were too large or the key was too small. But at any rate, it would not open any of them. However, on the second time round, she came upon a low curtain she had not noticed before, and behind it was a little door about 15 inches high. She tried the little golden key in the lock, and to her great delight, it fitted. Alice opened the door and found that it led into a small passage, not much larger than a rat hole. She knelt down and looked along the passage into the loveliest garden you ever saw. How she longed to get out of that dark hall and wander about among those beds of bright flowers and those cool fountains, but she could not even get her head through the doorway. As that passage was narrow, Alice could not enter that beautiful garden. There seemed to be no use in waiting by the little door, so she went back to the table, hoping she might find another key on it. But this time, she found a little bottle on it, and round the neck of the bottle was a paper label with the words "Drink me," beautifully printed on it in large letters. "What a curious feeling," said Alice after she finished drinking the liquid. "I must be shutting up like a telescope." Alice felt something was happening with her. She felt that she is shutting up like a telescope. And so it was indeed. She was now only 10 inches high and her face brightened up at the thought that she was now the right size for going through the little door into that lovely garden. She waited for a few minutes to see if she was going to shrink any further. After a while, finding that nothing more happened, she decided on going into the garden at once. When she got to the door, she found she had forgotten the little golden key on the table itself. And when she went back to the table for it, she found she could not reach it. When she had tired herself out with trying, the poor little thing sat down and cried. Alice had forgotten the key on the golden table, and as she was now only 10 inches, she was not able to get the key again. Alice felt very bad and she started crying. "Come, there's no use in crying like this," said Alice to herself. Soon her eye fell on a little glass box that was lying under the table. She opened it. She found in it a very small cake on which the words "Eat me" were beautifully marked in currants. Currants means small, dark, dried, seedless grapes. "Well, I'll eat it," said Alice. "And if it makes me grow larger, I can reach the key. And if it makes me grow smaller, I can creep under the door. So, either way, I'll get into the garden, and I don't care what happens." Alice was thinking that the cake will grow her larger or shrink her again. Alice was ready for the any of the thing to happen. She ate a little bite and said anxiously to herself, "Which way? Which way?" holding her hand on the top of her head to feel which way it was growing. And she was quite surprised to find that she remained the same size. To be sure, this generally happens when one eats cakes. But Alice was expecting to happen something different, as she was used to for this. The things were not normal for Alice, and it seemed quite dull and stupid for life to go on in the common way. But soon she realized that nothing was going to happen. So she set to work, and very soon she finished off the cake. Here the story ends. Hope you understood the story. Thank you.